Integrating change actions into your approval workflow is one of the easiest ways to introduce traceability to your data. We've previously looked at releasing files through SOLIDWORKS, and then using routes and route templates to release and promote objects through the lifecycle. Make sure you've watched those tutorials first, as they form the basis for making approvals using change management on the 3DEXPERIENCE platform. Let's show you how to release files using change actions. The change execution app is where our change management will take place, which comes with the SOLIDWORKS cloud services and the collaborative industry innovator role on the 3DEXPERIENCE platform. On our collaborative designer for SOLIDWORKS dashboard that we've been using throughout these tutorials, we'll add a new tab and call it Change Management. We'll open the compass and search for the app called Change Execution. Don't be surprised if you see two results here. The one we want has a small arrow in the top right corner, and we'll drag that onto the dashboard tab. Anytime you see an app with an arrow indicator, means that it can be added as a widget to the dashboard. We're ready to create a change action. Click the New Change Action button on the left-hand side of the widget. We'll give it the title of Cylinder Guard Release and the description. We'll double-check the 3D space credentials are correct and assign the priority and a due date. Clicking Create will take us into the properties of the change action itself, with the four tabs of Members, Proposed Changes, Realized Changes, and Approvals. We'll start off with the Members tab and consider who this change action should affect. Assignees can be added to undertake design tasks, approvers could be added for approvals, and users who still need to know about the progress of the tasks, but not necessarily take action, can be included under informed users. As this is a release that requires approval, the only one that we'll add is the approver. This could be select individual people or groups of approvers, but it can also be standardized by adding route templates instead. Here we'll search for this SOLIDWORKS approvals route template that we created in the previous video and click Add. The change action itself, as an object within the 3DEXPERIENCE platform, will go through the two-stage approval process contained within the route, and consequently, so too will the files that are attached to the change action. Now we'll check out the Proposed Changes tab. This is where we add any content that we're proposing making changes to. In this case, we'll add our cylinder guard part and its associated drawing. Head back to the My Data tab, then control and select the part and drawing files, and just drag them back across to the Change Management tab and drop them into the content area. Once we've added these items, we need to choose what happens when the change action is completed. What is our desired outcome of this change action? We want our content to be promoted to the release maturity state if this change action is approved. So let's expand the content items and check that they're being promoted to released. The outcome can be changed by using the drop-down on the right-hand side of the content and choosing Edit Proposed Change from the menu for each selected item. We can then activate the change action by changing its own maturity state from Draft to In Work via the drop-down under its name. At this point, if there was an assignee, they'd be notified of the change action and carry out the work. Once the work or tasks have been completed, the change action needs to be set to In Approval to initiate the approvals process. For us, this will activate the attached route template we added as an approver. When a change action is moved to In Approval, the attached items automatically change maturity state from In Work to Frozen. This is a state that protects the work from being locked to users or modified, as the items are governed under a change action. Let's review our to-do list under the My Tasks tab. When the change action is reviewed and approval is granted, then the design will be promoted to released. As the approver, we need to complete the design check task. When using change management, notice that the attachment on the task is not the content for review, but the change action itself. This protects against users without the Change Execution app from interacting with the file, and also provides a digital thread through to the associated files in the context of the change action. We'll approve the design check and the approved design task that follows to complete the route. On refreshing the Change Management tab, the change action will be marked as completed, and the attached objects, our part and drawing, will be marked as released. These will be visible under the Realized Changes tab, and the Approvals tab will show the progress of each stage. While the results of the change action are similar mechanically to approval routes created with a template, the key difference lies in traceability. Looking at the My Data tab and reviewing the cylinder guard drawing, we can see the Change tab within the item's information. This contains a complete history of the change action, what's been done, who did it and when, along with any comments and approval statuses. You simply don't get that level of traceability unless you use change actions along with an approval route template. Change actions bring a comprehensive level of traceability to your data. And if you want to learn more about working in the 3DEXPERIENCE platform, managing your data, or validating designs, then make sure you keep up with our tutorials over on our website, or get in touch with us via the details on screen.